Typhoons, cyclones, floods, earthquakes, and tsunami. These are just some of the natural disasters that ravage the Asia-Pacific region. The region's population density, social and economic circumstances, geography, and other factors result in disproportionate damage. In fact, the people of the Asia-Pacific region account for 90% of those around the world afflicted by natural disasters. Reinforcing effective disaster prevention schemes is a matter of major importance. Space technology, including Earth observation satellites, is being utilized in the Asia-Pacific region to mitigate the damage caused by natural disasters. With 52 organizations from 20 countries and 8 international organizations as members, Sentinel Asia is symbolic of the international cooperation in this field. Sentinel Asia was proposed at an Asia-Pacific Regional Space Agency Forum, or APRSAF meeting, held in Japan in 2005. It is a disaster management initiative leveraging Earth observation satellites capable of monitoring an extremely wide area to gain an early grasp of damage. The Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, or JAXA, serves as the secretariat.
What becomes even more important in the proactive use of satellite data for the purpose of mitigating disaster damages is collaboration between international space and disaster management agencies. A cooperative relationship going beyond national borders needs to be built from a humanitarian standpoint with the aim of reducing disaster damage.
When a disaster occurs, the relevant organization in the disaster-afflicted country submits an emergency observation request to Sentinel Asia. Satellites immediately record images of the afflicted area, and the data is distributed through the Internet and communication satellites. The Earth observation satellites of Japan, Korea, Thailand, and India currently serve the role of disaster observation.
The data from TOS can support Sentinel Asia, and if disaster such as a flood or landslide or forest fire, drought or tsunami or earthquake occur in other countries, if it's a serious disaster, so Thailand can support.
The Japanese wideband internetworking engineering test and demonstration satellite, WINS, was launched in February 2008. With a maximum speed of 1.2 gigabits per second, WINS is capable of the world's fastest telecommunications. It enables regions and islands in the Asia-Pacific that lack a broadband infrastructure to receive satellite data distributed by Japan by simply setting up a ground receiving station. Unlike other satellites, data from WINS can be received using an extremely small parabolic antenna, which can easily be set up almost anywhere.
We are their data center. We are their data provider. We can distribute the data from satellite, Earth observation satellite, to other countries immediately with the WINS. Because WINS have the very high speed communication, we will have the advantage for the high speed communication for Asian countries. It's very important.
Organizations in the Asia-Pacific region are launching efforts for the utilization of information provided by Sentinel Asia. Vietnam is a country that is experiencing market growth. At the same time, Vietnam is one of the world's greatest sufferers of natural disasters. The capital city, Hanoi, in particular, is susceptible to floods because it is situated in the Red River Delta, which is lower lying than the Red River. There are pumping stations located at various points to pump water into the river during torrential rains. However, they could not keep up with the concentrated downpour of 2008. North and central Vietnam was hit by heavy rain from late October, and floods broke out. Transportation was paralyzed. The floods left 22 people dead. The Vietnam news agency reported it as the worst flood in the past 25 years. An elderly woman with a field near the Red River said she lost everything in the flood. This field, in an inland area where peanuts and bananas are grown, was also flooded. This is a satellite image provided by Sentinel Asia. Rivers and lakes where water is present year-round are shown in black, while areas that were thought to have been flooded are highlighted in red. By doing so, it becomes possible to grasp the flooding situation in a single glance. Vietnam is proactively searching for ways to utilize this satellite image to prepare for future natural disasters.
I think PANSA data last year is a very unique source for us to understand how flood occurred, happened, and also how water can better discharge from the inland to the river. From such point of view, we can compute water amount degrees, and we can estimate the capacity of water discharge system, also relating to the pumping station, and if it is enough or not, how and where to improve.
The National Remote Sensing Center is also a member of Sentinel Asia. Various Vietnamese organizations hold expectations for Sentinel Asia and are involved in its activities.
I think it's a very, very good idea and very good organization. So some developing country like Vietnam, they can receive the Earth observation data freely, so we can use that data to control and mitigation the disaster problem in our country.
Representatives of the Asian Disaster Reduction Center, which receives the emergency observation requests, visited the Vietnam Academy of Science and Technology in February 2009. The aim was to identify ways to improve Sentinel Asia and enable even more effective activities. A field survey of local damage was also carried out. The purpose was to compare and verify damage against the data received from satellites. The knowledge acquired will be accumulated in order to enhance the precision of natural disaster observation.
International cooperation on disaster risk reduction is not a political issue. I think that international cooperation on the disaster risk reduction is a humanitarian assistance. In this context, those countries, such as Korea, Japan, Korea, India, and Thai, make the contribution to Sentinel Asia by providing their satellite imagery to Sentinel Asia is a very symbolic cooperation initiative for humanitarian assistance.
Lao PDR is surrounded by Vietnam, China, Myanmar, Thailand, and Cambodia. It is the only landlocked country in Southeast Asia. The Mekong River is an important trade route for Lao PDR. Fisheries also thrive here. However, the Mekong River flooded in 2008 for the first time in 42 years. The monsoon season arrived in late May, almost 1 month earlier than usual. As a result of heavy rains in August, at the height of the rainy season, the river's water level rose beyond dangerous levels. The flooding, with a focus on central Lao PDR, submerged many homes. Roughly 200,000 people were afflicted, including 11 dead. When the river flooded, the villagers gathered to save a statue of Buddha enshrined within this temple along the Mekong River. Lao PDR's National Remote Sensing Center carries out field surveys of areas that were affected by the floods. It also hopes to quantify the satellite images provided by Sentinel Asia and contribute to future disaster management.
After I analyze data, we will disseminate to the line agency or relevant institution to find the information how much area affected by flood. Also, how many people affected by flood by using satellite image. In the near future, Sentinel Asia, I think that is very useful for us.
Thailand is an industrializing nation representative of Southeast Asia. Bangkok, the capital, is an international city with towering skyscrapers, high-speed railways, and a subway system. The Geoinformatics Center of the Asian Institute of Technology in the suburbs of Bangkok has ground receiving stations for the Earth observation satellites Terra and Aqua. The GIC plays a central role in Sentinel Asia's data analysis activities.
Some number of countries are around us. We know with our experience, they are still not in a good position to do that analysis by themselves. Until they develop their capacities, we have to provide the new output, new products for them. So therefore, I think it will take some time for them to develop their capacities. Until that, we'll try to provide the good data as well as value-added products for them for their day-to-day disaster risk management activities.
The fact that the disaster prevention agencies of various countries are beginning to carry out their own processing and analysis shows that the use of Sentinel Asia and satellite data for disaster prevention is starting to become established at local agencies. Monitoring wildfires is another important mission of Sentinel Asia. Wildfires are often caused by burning undergrowth and peat bogs, which in turn ignite trees. Large wildfires break out every year in countries like Indonesia and Malaysia that have a large distribution of peat bogs and wetland. The fires could spread to neighboring countries, and the smoke easily spread beyond borders. The peat bogs and wetland forests of tropical regions in Asia, together with Siberia and the Amazon, are now starting to be seen as a massive source of carbon dioxide emissions. The information provided by Sentinel Asia, which utilizes satellites covering extensively wide areas, is extremely advantageous in fighting such wildfires. There's a possibility that monitoring wildfires could be a powerful card in the control of global warming if it can be used to minimize damage, says Professor Masami Fukuda of the University of Alaska Fairbanks, who is making efforts towards the detection of wildfires.
Satellites are one of the advantages to covering wide area and most areas detection fire. So this is a very important technique to detect fire as soon as possible. So this is the idea of Central Asia covering Asian regions, the most earliest fire detection. the other area like Africa and Latin America, they're also occurring huge fire in the regions. So once the Sentinel Asia develop the system, we may introduce this system to other regions like Africa and Latin America also.
Sentinel Asia is also involved in capacity building related to disaster prevention. The training program was established in 2007 by JAXA. A training session was held in February 2009 in Lao PDR.
And it's a great honor for Lao PDR to finally have the body to organize the fourth Sentinel Asia operation for operation training.
We should employ all measures, including Earth observation from satellites, in order to reduce disaster reduction. And we also have to cooperate in tackling with them.
These capacity development programs are carried out with the cooperation of the various organizations in the joint project team. A characteristic of the data gained through Sentinel Asia is that they can be processed over the internet. The aim is to train individuals using information and software that is easily accessible so that what is learned can be utilized by trainees immediately upon return.
Most of the countries are not fully equipped with space-based information. So this framework, the Sentinel Asia framework, will definitely help these countries.
I've been working for disaster management in our country. I just thought that this training will be helpful for us to manage disaster in our country. Since it's a satellite-based training, I think like it will be useful for us in our country.
I'm from Disaster Management Center. They are only the authority coordinate all the disasters in Sri Lanka. This agency started after tsunami, 2006. So we are very young agency. I will convey all this program and this skills what I have gained from here to my staff, my colleagues, and definitely I have to conduct that.
The large-scale wildfires in February 2009 in Victoria State, Southeast Australia, were a deadly disaster, with the death toll rising to over 200 as searches progressed. Sentinel Asia cooperated in the effort to mitigate the damage by providing satellite images from the start, when the wildfires first erupted.
I'm pleased to hear that India, Korea, and Thailand have been providing their Earth observation satellite data to Sentinel Asia. Japan will also further enrich the observation network.
At the end of the day, we have to use our technology in a wise way, and technology serves the well-being and progress of people. And therefore, I would say that this is a new way of networking, not networking just within Earth, but also outside of Earth, with our communities. And therefore, I usually think of the linkages and partnerships between the global, the regional, as well as our local communities. But now there is another level, and this is outer space technologies.
The goal of Sentinel Asia is to prevent and mitigate damage caused by natural disasters such as typhoons, floods, earthquakes, tsunami, volcanic eruptions, and wildfires, which recur in the Asia-Pacific region. Sentinel Asia will continue to build and strengthen its cooperative relationship with countries of the Asia-Pacific and strive to alleviate disasters.